We come this night of all nights to stand before your holy presence. In this holiday season, we are so easily distracted from the precious gift that we have received in Christ Jesus. So as we celebrate his birth tonight, allow your spirit to open our hearts to the sacredness of this moment and to the beauty of your grace. May your glorious light, given so many years ago, radiate within us, piercing into the darkness of our own fears and uncertainties. Enable us to rejoice with the angels' song of peace and their message of hope, now and forever. For this we pray in Christ's holy name. Amen. You may be seated. I welcome you on this holy night of worship as we complete our observance of Advent. My prayer is, as we take a momentary pause from our busy holiday gatherings, that this Christmas Eve communion service will be a meaningful moment in our celebration of Christmas. I really hope that this service will stir within each one of us the same awe and wonder that the shepherds and the magi must have felt upon bowing before the presence of the Christ child. We shall begin with the lighting of the Advent wreath as we recall the great promises announced by the prophets of old predicting Christ's birth. Betty will lead us in a responsive reading of those Old Testament passage from the prophet Isaiah.
The sun will no more be your light by day, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you.
For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you.
See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples.
But the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you.
Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Hear now, you house of David, is it not enough to try the patience of men? Will you try the patience of God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign.
The virgin will be with child, and will give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel. God is with us.
We shall once again celebrate that first Christmas in both word and song. We will hear each section of that beloved story read to us from Scripture. Then we will follow the reading with a related carol, continuing until we hear and sing the entire story tonight. We will start with Elaine reading about Mary from the Gospel of Luke.
Thank you. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Now the birth of Jesus was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins."
Just seems to disappear.
it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were complete for her to be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
The star, which they had seen in the east, went before them
till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
John writes in his gospel, "In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not comprehended it. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. The Word became flesh, took up residence among us. We have observed his glory, the glory as the one and only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." We now light the Christ candle and complete the lighting. Our Advent is fully lit and burning. Listen. Do you hear it? Look. Can you see it? I'm beginning to hear the faint sound of a muffled song. I can almost see the glow of a brilliant light. Listen. Look. There it is. Can you behold that same light and that same song piercing the darkness, which still keeps this world in awe of its glorious hope? Can you hear those words now, which have continually echoed down through the passage of time? Fear not. I bring you great tidings of great joy, which shall be for all peoples. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill to men. This song of the angels transcends time, continuing to fill the darkness once again tonight. I hope you can hear their words as we gather tonight to celebrate the good news of God's or Christ's advent among us. We feel almost compelled just to come tonight and to bow down before Him. In this quiet moment, we join with the faithful from around the world to meditate on the magnitude of that birth. It is almost incredulous that the King of Kings appeared to us as a babe in a stable. Yet this heavenly wonder has cast its peaceful calm over every generation celebrating His birth. For that was a very holy night, the night of all nights. In this service tonight, we remember just how special it really was. Our communion tonight is a renewal of our faith, believing that God became flesh, dwelt among us, died on Calvary, arose from the grave, and ascended upon high, so that we might have life eternal in Him. That is the good news which has been proclaimed around the globe in every generation, transforming our history. Tonight is not just about Christ's birth, He grew up, nor is it just about His death, He lives, but rather it is about renewing that promise of God's presence among us. It is when the past, the present, and the future merge together in a single instant. Tonight, we participate in that moment of eternity with our Lord and Savior by sharing with Him in communion. In order to partake of that promise of peace and eternal hope in the midst of an increasing darkness about us, Jesus has invited all His followers to share of the bread and the cup together around His table. I believe that this communion service helps us transcend all the darkness that we experience in our own lives. We simply come and humbly bow down and offer our worship of honor and devotion to Him. We sing because of the joy He brings into our life at His birth, and we rejoice because of His eternal hope promised in His resurrection. We're celebrating His life that shines among us. Therefore, we assemble around His table to remember not only His birth, but His death and resurrection. With all the Advent candles burning, we embrace the radiance of His glorious light coming among us. So in our Christmas Eve communion, it is a fulfillment of that sacred significance of His birth. For indeed, this is a holy night.
Thank you.
Participate in the closing circle holding a candle that has been lit from the Christ candle in Advent wreath. To partake of communion, I invite you to make a circle and come up that far left aisle over there by the windows. You will go to Wanda first. She will hand you a piece of the broken bread. Next, move over to me, dip your bread into the juice of the chalice, and eat it. Then you will go over to Kim and get your candle. And then you'll continue to make a circle with your candle until, in the end, we have a circle around the sanctuary. If you choose not to participate in communion, we still want you to participate in the closing circle. Just pass by the communion and walk to Kim and get your candle and then be a part of the closing circle. And then we will form that circle on the outside of this sanctuary with all our candles burning brightly. And if you're unable to come forward for communion, remain seated and we will take communion to you. Let's stand as we say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Amen. The night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and broke it. And when he had given thanks, he said, "This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, he poured it, he gave thanks, and he said to them, "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you. Take and drink in remembrance of me." As we are standing in our circle, our lights are the lights of Christ spreading in the darkness. Each small flame symbolizes God's glory shining in the world. Our circle of light will continue burning through the benediction and closing chorus, then gently blow them out. Our circle will not be broken. It will only spread out into the community. When we depart here, we invite you to take your candle home with you and then relight it as a reminder of Christ's advent among us as you celebrate Christmas. My benediction comes from the Gospel of Luke. Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light for all people and the glory of your presence. Amen.
Thank you.
carefully.
Merry Christmas.